when you look at Sri Lanka, we look at India. If we look at Amazon, Apple, all these companies, the big names are there. What is the reason that they're not even batting an eyelid at our direction right now? What do you think? What are we missing in order to get that?
So there's a couple of things I would say. Look, let's look at our performance. We have been open economy since 1978. BOI in multiple forms has been in this country since 1978. We have attracted close to about 18 billion because port, when Hambantota was leased out, that also been counted. So 18 billion is what we can speak for since 1978 to today. So there lies the fundamental issue we have. And it's a manifestation, you ask, what is our brand? Right? So when you have 1,000 agencies fighting, and if I want to get Microsoft, it's not a roadshow, it's not a letter to Satya Nadella, hey, Sri Lanka, this Indian Sagre Mutu Ate, right? Come in, invest. No. It is understanding the company's strategic intent in the region. What segments? Because Microsoft, you have devices, you have software, you have internet services, you have cloud services. What aspect of it would they look at coming in this part of the world? Why would I compete, or how can Sri Lanka provide a better value proposition than India, than Malaysia? And how and what sort of incentives should we provide? And engage them at the boardroom level on a 6 months, year, 2 year period to be able to get them to come here. Right, all the value that India sees, all the FDIs India sees, has been a 6 to 8 year journey. This because Invest India was set up in 2009 and they completely reformed in 2016 around, where a huge private-public partnership came in and they went to market. And that is the outcome you're seeing now. As always, Sri Lankans, we like to see results like this without doing the hard work. So the second part of to come to that is, so I'm saying you need to fight a different battle. True. Second part I'm coming, Manish, is the brand you talked about. Because today what's happening to the brand? No one lobbies brand in European Union. Not to the extent that I would love to see, and the way that the countries like Singapore and EDB would do in their heydays. Right, they had offices. I'm not saying to just go run around and do offices, but you need to understand the game you have to play.
Yeah, the lobby.
The we are playing a different chess game now. We have to equip ourselves. We can't expect better results doing the same thing. And then look at the branding. If you ask companies, what do Sri Lanka stands for? Right, Swascom will say Island of Ingenuity, which is a great brand. Tourism will say so Sri Lanka. Stock exchange will have another thing.
Where should the
Port City will have another thing?
Yeah, and it's gonna be big as well. So, do you think the government should start putting one thing together and ask everybody to utilize this? Because you remember those days when you look at the brand made in China, that's not the best quality or anything of that sort. But now see how they've changed. Made in China, if you look at an Apple phone or any kind of phone that is made in China, so that particular brand value has gone double, but they never changed the made in China slogan. Do you think the government needs to push more on this?
I think there are different paths different countries have taken, right? Post the World War, the path Japan took, secondly, closely emulated by Korea, then the Taiwan and China. They all have their own brands, made in Korea, made in Japan, made in Taiwan, made in China, but they took different paths. So the question is, what is our unique path for Sri Lanka, right? So India went through the campaign of Made in India. Modi did a huge roadshow, a huge top-of-the-mind awareness. But I think the important thing is to say is like, what is our value proposition and how do I communicate that value proposition in the most consistent way to the different segments so that it resonates with the individuals? Now the question is, today it doesn't happen. Now, Port City has its own branding. Sri Lanka has somewhat of a branding through T Board has one message, Tourism Board has another, Stock Market has another one, BOI tries to do its own branding, Slascom and ICTA, we get together do Island of Ingenuity. What's our master brand? Right? And then it's a, you can't have a port city without Sri Lanka growth story. You can't have a Sri Lanka without port city growth story, because if you're going for a service industry or a service led growth, look at Dubai, look at Qatar. Those were the catalysts. So port city is the right catalyst. But now the question is, how do you do that branding? Right. Now you can't expect the government to drive it. We've never been the best communicators, let's be frank.
Yeah, of course.
Whichever the government it is. Right? So the most important thing is a private-public partnership, where the private sector, because we are moving towards more of a private sector level-led growth. So the I think that's a good model if you look at Invest India. The private sector needs to drive and set the tone. And that is, should be an onus. Because in the past, when the private sector ownership is a lobbying, that's not what I'm saying. You need to co-own the future and the industrial segment. The policy has to come from there, right? For example, Chamber of Commerce, ICC, there's a few other chambers who are trying to do that. Why not get together? Right? Because we are all talking about the country. Because at the end of the day, there's a country and the people. To serve that, you have political establishment. To serve that, you have entities, people, unions, or whatever it is. So if you're all looking for this whole grandeur thing of serving the country and creating the world that we all like to see in, we have to get together. And I firmly believe that's an effort that has to be led by BOI, but everyone has to come together, because it's not who's the kingpin there, but it is a collective effort that needs to come in, because then you have a consistent message. Because two ways, right? So you do a tourism one today, then I'm doing another ICT one today. No, what are the two connections you happen? Because if tourism goes and talks about Sri Lanka as the best place to come in, and you're talking about digital nomads, hey, ICT should also talk about, like, what are we doing, right? Then you can also talk about from BOI, from universities, and come and say, hey, come and set up. This is kind of the infrastructure we're going to build in. Hey, we're building 10 city universities. We're building some, tech parks. You see the cohesion. So then you have a multiply effect of the brand we are building.
Absolutely.
Right? That is what we are missing. And we have to start doing it quickly, because otherwise we are losing the plot.